the Brett Hollander Show on WBAL, and joining us right now to share her thoughts on the passing of Congressman Elijah Cummings is former Baltimore City Mayor Sheila Dixon. And Mayor Dixon, thank you so much for coming on. We appreciate it so much. When I say the name Elijah Cummings, what's the first thing that comes to your mind?
Well, first of all, he was a tremendous giant in Baltimore City in the state of Maryland. He devoted himself to civil rights, his passionate speeches, you know, his public servants of love, and his commitment to mentor so many of us. I'm remembered when, I think at this time I might have been mayor. I don't know if I was city council president or mayor. And we get invited to a lot of dinners. And we were sitting at the table together, and he said, so how do you keep your weight down? What are you doing? And I'm always, my conversation always is surrounded by health and fitness. And so I said, well, Elijah, I work out. I try to eat right. I said, now see, this meal we're having right now, I'm not going to eat that dessert. And he said, you're not going to eat the dessert? I said, nope, I'm going to eat. I eat special anyway. I don't eat meat and things. I said, now see, that dessert is not probably worth the calories. And he laughed about it. He said, you know what, I'm going to pick that up and I'm going to do that. So next time I saw him at another event, he said, I started working out on a treadmill. I'm not eating those desserts at the table. But he was just a decent person. And we've had a relationship for a long time. And when I was in public office, when I was out, you know, I could call him. Mondays was a great time when you can come down to his office, down by the Meyerhof, and just sit down and have conversations. I remember Freddie Gray and everything that took place there. He was the calmness during that whole ordeal. He's going to be missed by many of us, but his spirit lives in us, and we have learned so much to be able to continue to serve for that next generation, because it's what he always thought about.
Did you ever lean on him, Mayor Dixon, for advice on policy or what to do in this situation, either as city council president or as mayor?
I leaned on him, and he leaned on me. I leaned on him as relates to some of the mandates that we received from the federal government, either through the Department of Environment, the EPA, or when we had the consent decree dealing with water and wastewater. But we weren't getting any resources and funding from the federal government. I would lean on him and say, hey, how can you help us to get resources to come to the city to deal with many of the infrastructures that are falling apart and that we are having to deal with? And he was extremely instrumental in that. When President Obama came up with the stimulus funds, you know, he and I talked about how the city of Baltimore had shovel-ready projects ready to go, and how this stimulus would help us, and vice versa. He asked me, this is after I left public office and crime was out of control, he would talk to me and say, Sheila, what is it that you did in order to get crime down? What do we need to do now? So we always had advice and conversations about what was happening here in the city.
And finally, Mayor Dixon, the way he kind of broke his life down, there's a big national stage where he rose to great heights on a big forum in the House of Representatives, but his eyes and his brain as he looked towards a life back home in Baltimore, how did he break that down personally day-to-day, thinking local as opposed to thinking national?
Well, first of all, he was a powerful leader in the Congress. But he broke it down by not forgetting where he came from and what he did in being a Baltimorean and the effect and the impact that it has locally, you know, despite dealing with issues that were internationally and representing us as a congressman. It always came back to home and what impact and difference he could make for the citizens here in Baltimore, and particularly our young people here in Baltimore.
Yeah, that seems to be a theme today.
Yeah, so my prayers are with his wife, his family, his children. I mean, this is a big loss, but it just says that more and more his example is needed in all of us in some kind of way where he really had an impact on each of our lives.
Mayor Dixon, we appreciate your thoughts on this so much. Thank you.
Thank you.